Bamba Rescue 2020. Bamba is an organization that is for and by private Ayurvedic doctors, and as General Secretary, it is my duty to ensure that such activities are promoted, the benefit of members and the Ayurveda community as a whole. As the name suggests, we are determined to overcome all hurdles and sharpen our minds. Bamba Rescue 2020 is a program developed by Bamba aimed for the Ayurvedic community. We are here to bring a source of continuous learning to the field of Ayurveda. We believe in positive learning with a positive attitude. For an experienced doctor, this is a place where he can refresh his memories. For a fresher, this is a place where he reinvents himself. And for us all, this is a place where we relive the glorious days when the pursuit of knowledge was in our hearts. Let me now call upon our president, Dr. Krishnadas P. for his words. Sir.
Thank you, Dr. Shyamohan, our secretary. Dear doctors, Bamba is always with you for your support and guidance. We are duty-bound to cultivate a positive culture and steady growth among our members. It is our vision that Ayurveda becomes a global medicinal discipline. Let us prepare ourselves for that inevitable future. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Let me now call upon our treasurer, Dr. Suresh P.K.
Thank you, Dr. Shyam. Good evening, dear friends and doctors. The motive behind these classes is to build confidence and the right attitude in clinical practice. I'm sure that beginners as well as the experienced doctors will cherish this always. Thank you. Thank you very much. And heartily welcome our today's guest, Dr. Naveen Chandra Joshi. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
It is important for us to bring these classes at the lowest of the cost to the participants, and sponsors are our way of doing things. We thank Vaidyaratham PSYDS Ayurvedashala Kottakkal for helping us with that mission. Thank you, Ayurvedashala Kottakkal. Just a special announcement. All our videos, all the Rescue videos are available on our website. The website is given on the screen right now. Please go register. Once you register, you go to an accounts page. You can log into your accounts page, and on your accounts page, there are more than 100-150 videos available on different subjects of Rescue. Today is in fact 183rd Bamba Rescue class, and all are available on our video. Please do go there and check it out. Two other programs Bamba is conducting: Bamba Focus and Bamba Excel. Bamba Focus is a theory-based study on the Brihatrayis. We have also Sanskrit and allied subjects, which we have opened for everyone. Excel is a more practical oriented study for the clinicians. So these are the Sanskrit and allied classes that we have opened up for all the Ayurvedic fraternity. Everyone is welcome for this. The details and the meeting ID and password is given below. You can take a screenshot of that. The Sanskrit and Sanskrit classes are held every Friday morning, 6:30 to 8:30. And allied subjects like Jyotisha, Vastu, etc. Is done on Tuesday morning, 6:30 to 8:30. So if you are interested, you can join. This is another initiative by Bamba. We are co-organizing. I'm very sorry. Excuse me. It is not an initiative, Bamba. It is an initiative by Vagbeda Sarani, an organization which have been conducting Ashtanga Hridaya Satra, a program for nearly 17 years. And this time we are co-organizing this with Vagbeda Sarani. And if you are a student of Ayurveda, this is a place, this is a program that you have to attend. It will completely change the way you look at Shastra. And you can contact Dr. M. Prasad, whose number is given below. Again, take a screenshot and you can contact him for more details about the program. Also, just want to tell you, this is an 8-day program. We are going to start on the 16th of October. The fees is only 500 rupees because this is aimed for the propagation of Shastra rather than anything else. So before we start the class, let me give you a few basic etiquettes of this class. All questions are to be posted in the chat and we shall go through them once the class is over. For best stability, use a laptop and high-speed net connection. If your video is on, please make sure you're in front of a professional background. In case of any disruption, kindly check your network connection and wait patiently for the class to resume. You may raise your hand if you have a question to ask after the presentation. Make sure you have your full name displayed so it is professional. So with that, we come to today's speaker. So before I hand over the mic to Dr. Naveen, let me give you a brief introduction of him. Dr. Naveen Chandra Joshi currently works as Associate Professor in the Department of Swastavritta and Yoga, Uttarakhand Ayurveda University, Dehradun. Completed BAMS, Bachelor of Ayurveda with Modern Medicine and Surgery from Sri CSJM University, Kanpur, UP. Postgraduate Diploma in Preventive and Promotive Healthcare from Apollo Hospital, Research Education Foundation, Hyderabad. Postgraduate Diploma in Yogi Sciences from HNB, Garhwal University, Srinagar, and MD from Vikram University, Ujjain MP. Over 20 years of clinical and academic experience, life member of National Academy of Panchakarma, National Integrated Medical Association and NASIA, founder member of Ayush Darpan Foundation Trust India, edited Ayush Darpan Health Magazine from year 2010, best doctor awardee from Government of Madhya Pradesh for successful participation in Simhastha Kumbha, participated as resource person, guest speaker in many national and international seminars, received Dhanvantari Award, Kumaun Kesari Award, and Uttarakhand Ratna Sri Award from different organizations. Editorial member of Sanjeevani, a journal published by Government Ayurvedic Medical Officers of Uttarakhand. Master trainer of Government of Uttarakhand for Marma Science and Therapy. Master trainer for ASHA and ANM training programs. Ministry of Ayush. Master trainer of Panchakarma training to medical officers. Trained more than 200 Ayurvedic medical officers, practitioners, and students of Marma Science and Therapy. Organizing president of many international and national conferences on Ayurveda, participated as invited guests on in different media platforms like Doordarshan, Akashvani, etc. Organizer of more than 100 health awareness camps, yoga camps in different organizations, universities, and schools. So without further ado, let me call upon Dr. Naveen Joshi for his presentation. Hello, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Shyam Mohan. It's my privilege.
Yes, sir. Welcome to Resolute, sir.
Yeah, to present the topic, the Marma, the Angiresi way of treatment. So I just want to share my screen, it's allowed.
Sure, sir.
Namaste to all of you, myself, Dr. Naveen Joshi. I already introduced to the orator and the coordinator of this program, Dr. Naveen Chandra Joshi, I'm MD. I'm just presenting this, what is Marma science, and it is Angiresi way of treatment. That is the title. So I just want to present a new view about the Marma. God is great and you are free to believe whenever you were and have been given free to choose the path that we take in life, seek the truth and seek God, and you will find him. Quotes inspire you to be a better believer on God. So in my opinion, whatever I'm going to present you, and this starts from this mantra, that is Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushti Vardhanam Urvarukumivabandhanath. This is a mantra which first, this is a divine mantra which itself explains the painless death which we demand, which we just pray from the God Shiva, that please give us a death without pain. So now I'm just coming to the point, everybody's just, you all know that the body is the means of fulfilling all religions, means duties. So it is necessary to keep body healthy. So sarim adhyam khalu dharma sadhanam. You all know this quote. And just I am coming to the quote, that what is Marma? So Marma, if you come to the point, it is a Vedic technique. It is a Vedic science, which is divided in four folds, the Angiresi, the Manusya, the Atharvani, and the Daivi. So I focused only on the Angiresi way of treatment. The Angiresi is a way of treatment in which the own body parts, the areas, body's areas, is utilized for treating the person. And this is a Vedic era, this is a very popular treatment that is known as the Angiresi treatment. As we still observe that during the Anganyas and the Karanyas, we already touch over these points. That is the Risadanyas, Mantranyas, Matrika Nyas, Vyapaka Nyas, Suram Nyas. These are the Vedic techniques in which we still just touch these points. So just I am coming to point that body is a miniature replica of this universe. That is Yatha Pinde, Tatha Brahmande. This is a reference, means our body is a miniature replica of this universe and the Marma. Now come to the Marma. The Marmas are the vital areas where the energy resides as prana. Means prana are the part of the cosmic energy, which when associated in our body along with mans, sira, snayu, asti and sandhi, then only the new creature form a living body. A body without these prana means if there is mans, sira, snayu, asti and sandhi, but prana is absent, then there is no concept of Marma. So these are just as God, means powerful in both the senses that creator, nurturer, and destroyer. All the three forms are present in the form of prana. So we get the three names as a Brahma, Vishnu, or Mahesha, the creator, nurturer, and destroyer. These all are the energies, and we give them a different name. So we all know that the Vedas are the oldest treasure of knowledge. And if you look the Ayurvedic history, there is a history of 5,000 or 8,000 years old, which is documented history in Charaka, Susruta, or Vagbhata, Stangradaya. But if you look at the Vedas, they are the oldest treasure of knowledge. As you all know that there are so many the historical changes, there are so many universities in India like Nalanda and Takshila where the Vedic literatures were present at ancient time. But there are so many political changes which results like Ikhtiyaruddin Muhammad bin Bakhtiyar Khilji type of people who destroyed this Nalanda University, and all the Vedic literatures get destroyed, and the same knowledge flourished from this region, this Aryavart region, to the China, Korea, and different countries, and they develop their sciences like acupressure and different sciences. So I'm just coming to the point how this Angirasi mode of the treatment or the method of treatment, that is a Vedic treatment, how this functions, how this act, and how what is the meaning of this Angirasi way of treatment. So we all know that according to the medical definition, the specific parts of the body which are very vulnerable to trauma, they are known as marma. You all know about this, and it is also mentioned at Maryanti iti marmani or maranam karitvat iti marmani. Now come to some examples I'm just putting in front of your screen. Trauma to these vital areas of body may lead to death or many other complications regarding physiological functions and anatomical configurations disturbance. I'm just giving an example. This is a photograph of Jacob Miller, who was shot dead at the Battle of Chickamauga on 19 September 1863. And the person survived around 31 years with a bullet in his face, an example of Vishalagna Marma. So this is a very good example of Vishalagna Marma, which is mentioned in by Shushruta. We all know the Battle of Ramayana, the injury of the Lankadipati Ravana, the dust injury to the Navi Marma leads to demisal of the Lankadipati Ravana. And if you come to the history, the demise of Lord Krishna, the injury to Pad Tal Hriday Marma also leads to the demise of the Lord Krishna. These are some historical examples. So we come to the Jesus Christ. So we can see the injury to Tal Hriday and Manimanda Marma leads to the demise of the Jesus Christ. And another story is also, if we look at the demise of Shramana Kumara, which is very obedient to his father, which was very obedient to his father and mother, and one injury of Sthapani Marma leads to his demise. As you all know, that is the Vishalagna Marma. So this is also another example we just got from the history. Another example is the Philip Hughes, which is a cricketer, an injury of ball to the Kanth Marma in a domestic international match played in Australia leads to his death. So this is also an example of a marma injury, means vital part injured and leads to death. Again, another example is the demise of cricketer Raman Lamba, which is a very growing cricketer at the age of early 90s, and a ball just hit on his Sankh Marma leads to his immediate death. So there are some interesting facts just I am presenting in front of you. As we all know, in accidental cases, some people die without massive outside injuries, but some people get extensive outside injuries. They become healthy after proper treatment. It means there are some points which, if injured, person dies. And when these points, if these points may safeguard, the person recovers. So these vital points are important for the survival of the human being. So just I am coming to the main point, that is historical background of the marma science. Vedas are, just I previously elaborated that Vedas are the treasure house of knowledge. And the Vedic medical science, we find a fourfold classifications. One is Atharvini, second one is the Angirasi, third one is the Devi, and fourth one is the Manushyaja. Atharvini, as you all know, the spiritual upliftment, the treatment by which the spiritual upliftment, and we can just treat a person's mental status. Angirasi is a way of treatment in which just we stimulate certain body's points and just we treat by, and the Marma Chikitsa is a part of that Angirasi Chikitsa. While the Devi is a Panchabhautik Chikitsa in which the five basic elements were used. And the Manusija Chikitsa is a classification in which the treatment, the modality is developed by human being that incorporates in this Chikitsa. So historical background of different system of medicine, if you look, Marma science and Marma therapy is the oldest way of healing in the world. If you look at the Ayurveda, it has 5-10,000 years old history. Chinese medical system is also of same history, while the Arabian medical system has 1,400 years of history. And modern medical science, less than 300 years, and homeopathy, more than 150 years. Many other folk medical systems were present in different parts of the globe time to time, but they are not in existence today. But this science, this Vedic science, it is still in existence, and just I'm presenting in front of you means there is something. So this is a picture in which you are showing the Anganyas, an important part of Vedic rituals, in which the pandits, the gurus, just performing a ritual in which they are touching the vital points. That is Anganyas. Anganyas. And we are just blowing Sankha or conker cell, and we don't know that this blowing also indirectly stimulates some of the Marma points of the country region. Again, we are blowing a pipe in Buddhist tradition, and the same, it also stimulates the Marma points of the neck region. So there are so many similarities. So again, I am coming to the points. We all know that 17 Marma, total 107 Marma points, 37 in neck and head region, 44 in extremities, 14 in back, and approximately, and there are 12 Marma points in thorax and abdomen. So this is a percentage of Marma according to the site and location at which you look the distribution, and 34%, 13%, 11%, 21 and 21%. These are the distribution in the upper extremity, lower extremity, chest, abdomen, back and above neck. And these are as the quality wise distribution, as you all know, some are fatal, 19 are Sadhya Pranahar Marma, and having an Agniya Mahabhut Pradhan, 33 are delayed foot fatal, Kalantra Pranahar Marma, Somya Agni, 3 are fatal after foreign body removal, that is known as Visalagna, which I have already given the 3 historical examples. 44 are disabling, means they are Vaikallikar Marmas, and 8 Marma points are painful. These are the percentage wise according to the structure. If you look, Sira Marmas are more in number, and the second one is Snayu Marma, and then Sandhi, Mansa, and Asthi Marma. These are the percentile distribution of the Marmas in our body. So now come to the point, as you all know, that there are 107 switches in our body, and these switches are very important in relation to the also fatality, as well as in relation to the clinical benefits. So I'm just presenting you that there are two situations. One situation is that there is a house in which the light is present, another is totally dark. Means if you don't know about the switches in our body, your body, then just you are residing in a home in which electricity is there, but you are not able to find the switches for off and on, and just getting the instruments to be started. So always these points are very important. So we have keep our knowledge perfectly how to stimulate these points and where these points are located and what are the nature of these points. So if you want to operate correct electrical equipment, you need a right switch, and in the same way manner, correct way to switch on and off is also a condition to operate the electrical equipment. This is practical approach. And same way, if you wrongly put out your finger to unwanted switch, and this happens. So I'm just coming to the point, my dear friends, my dear doctors, in which I'm just teaching these Marmas beginners and advanced course to my doctors regularly from the lockdown, and so many students have also joined here. What I'm telling to you that these switches are very important. God has given these switches in our body. If you want, there are two aspects of these switches. One is the preventive aspect and another is the treatment aspect. So people don't know about the preventive aspect. By stimulating these Marma points, we also prevent we also maintain our health by simply doing self marma therapy. And how this can be performed, and how, and this comes from directly from the Angirasi way of treatment. As during the Angirasi or the Anganyas and Karanyas, we observe that we touch a certain vital point, we touch like the Ansa Marma, like Urvi, Ani, Hridaya, and different time Marma points. So I'm just coming to the some important clinical important point. And if you learn from me in this lecture, and if you use to your patients, and if they are getting benefit, then it's, I think that this lecture will be fruitful. So I'm just coming to some points. Like first point, I'm just coming, just look. Sushruta had mentioned that Mariyanti iti Marmani, but the name what Sushruta gave, that is Adipati. Just come to this point. This is Adipati Marma. Adipati Marma, what do you mean by the Adipati? Adipati means the master, the king, the governor. And simply, this point is situated in our torcular herophila. Torcular herophila or the top of the vertex. Top of the vertex means in the top of the vertex. And how we approach to this point? Simply with the five fingers. As you all know, for if you want to meet with the king or the governor or a person who is of great, powerful person, great importance, then you have to approach with proper honor. So we just put our honor with giving a five finger stimulation. As you all know that our thumb represents the Agni, while the small fingers represent the Jala, and the other fingers represents correspondingly the Akas. So by these five fingers, we just stimulate by putting our five fingers over the top of the vertex. And how we can stimulate these points? We simply press and release, press and release, press and release. Frequency of stimulation means how many times. If you are a physically fit person, then you have to stimulate it 5 to 8 times. And if a person is suffering from any ailments, then the 15-18 times stimulation is needed. As you all know that Adipati Marma is a Sadhya Pranahar Marma having an Agni in nature, and it is located at the top of the vertex having an half angula pramana. And it is a very effective marma to control, to govern all the activities which is going inside your body, especially like the nervous motor control as well as the other control. It is a very relaxing marma, but there are some protocols associated with the stimulation of this marma point. Simply, you know that if there is a king, if there is a governor, or there is a prime minister, or you say it is a master point. So there are five also top ministers or top bureaucrats or top level of think tanks is present surrounding this point, and that is known as the Simanta Marma. As you all know, there are five number Simanta Marma, two situated at the coronal suture, one in the sagittal suture, and two at the back, that is at the lumbroidal suture. And the five Marma, and normally whenever we feel certain problem or certain type of depression, this is our origin, the normal, this is normal action. We just put our hands like this, but we don't know. We never observe that by doing this, we are stimulating actually our Simanta Marma, which is in number two in the coronal suture, in number one in the sagittal suture, and in number two in the lumbroidal suture. So by there is a method for stimulating this Marma point, and how we can stimulate. Simply, you can place your hypothenar eminence in this way, and just put your five fingers, and the thumb should be placed at the lumbroidal suture, means your small finger and the other fingers should be placed properly at the coronal as well as the sagittal suture, and thumb should be placed at the lumbroidal suture. And by just simply press and release, press and release, press and release, you can stimulate your Simanta Marma. And Simanta Marma is a beautiful marma which just help Adipati to incorporate the plan of action, whatever them. And this is a Kalantara Pranahar Marma having Soma and Agni qualities, and of 4 Angula Pramana, that is the Mustika Pramana. So these 6 Marma points are very important, in the sense that all Marma points are associated with the Sahasrara Chakra. As you all know, this is at the top of the Brahma Randhra, and it is a, you all know that this chakra is a very important, which connects you with the supernatural power, that is the cosmic power. So Dadipati and Simant Varmas are those Varmas which are mentioned as a Sadhya Pranahar Varma and Kalantara Pranahar Varma. But if you properly stimulate and you properly approach to these Varma points, you will get excellent results in your different. You observe these results in your body also, and also in the patients also. So my dear doctors, I'm just telling that, yes, one aspect is Mariyanti iti Marmani or Maranam Karitvati iti Marmani. But the another aspect is that these points are very beautiful points and you got excellent results in your patients. So I hope that you just identify the location of these 6 points. One is the Adipati, located at the torcular herophila, and other 5, the Simant, one located at the coronal, 2 Marma points at the coronal, 1 at the sagittal just in front of the Adipati, and 2 at the lambroidal suture, which is just nearby to the Adipati Marma. It means 5 Marmas surrounds the Adipati Marma, and these Marmas are Simant Marma. So now come to the next Marma point. I think that there are so many students who joined these sessions. They already know about these points as they joined my classes also. So this is not a new thing which I am just presenting here, but for those who just first time they encountered these things that, oh, we studied these Marma points in Sushruta Sharira Sthana Marma Nirdesh Sharira Adhyaya as a Mariyanti iti Marmani, but Dr. Naveen Joshi is just presenting here that these are the points which can be used for the chikitsa purpose. And I am just mentioning, yes, this is a Vedic chikitsa and having an Angirasi division or classification. So now come, my dear friends, to the next point. Just this is for revision for the old doctors who just know about these points. But for the new which are joining these sessions, just focus these points. These are excellent points for the prevention as well as for the treatment purpose. So now come to the next Marma point that is located at your mastoid process. I'm just showing you at the just lower end of your ear, and that is the mastoid process. And you just approach this point like this. And you all know that you just observed that our gurus, our pandit also just put here chandana. And so this is a very important point. The approach is off with the thumb, and you just put pressure, release, press, release, press, release. And always remember that the frequency is of 0.8 second and the number of stimulation should be of the patient is suffering from any type of ailment related with the ear disorder or anything, whatever. And then in any Marma points, it should be 15 to 18. And the frequency is of 0.8 second. 0.8 second connects with the cardiac cycle, and 15 to 18 minutes per minute just connects with the respiratory rate. So as you all know, this is a Vidur Marma, and this is of the Snayu Marma and Vaikalikar Marma and Soumya, and having a half angula pramana. And this is very important Marma points. You all know that there are nadis, which is known as the Payaswini and Sankhini, which connects with the right and left ear channel, and that corresponds with the stereoacoustic functions as well as the auditory functions. So this stimulation of these points prevents you from any auditory ailments, while if a person is suffering from any type of auditory problems, this points is very important. So now come to the next point. In Maharshi Sushruta, it is mentioned that Dhruvo Antaro Rupari Karna Lalato Madhye Sankho Tatra Shadyo Maranam. So I just want to show this point. I think that this slide is not present here, so no problem. I am just coming to just look at my video. I am in the camera. Just come to 1 minute. Yes, just look at my video frame, and I am just showing you how this Sankh Marma, how you can identify this Sankh Marma. Just I am stopping my PPT share, and I am just pointing my video here. So Dhruvo Antaro Rupari Karna Lalato Madhye Sankho Tatra Sadyo Maranam. So just draw an imaginary line. Sir, please explain what is the meaning of name of each Marma why the particular name came. At last, I will answer your questions. Please, my dear doctors, wait for some time. I just explained the Adhipati, the Simanta. So there is, I think that there is no confusion. Simanta Adhipati is at the torcular herophila, and how you approach with five fingers. And the way of approach is the press, release, press, release, press, release, press, release. And 0.8 second is the stimulation time, means each press and release, the time is the 0.8 second. That is a cardiac cycle. And the frequency of means how many times you have to stimulate. If you are a healthy person, then 5 to 8 times. And if you are suffering from any type of ailment related with the mental disorders, anxiety, depression, or body's any parts, functional, uncontrolled function, motor uncontrolled function, then you have to stimulate 15 to 18 times. So now come to the next point. Just this is a Vidur Murma, which I already explained to you. This is at the mastoid process at the base of the ear. And as you all know, it is a Snayu Murma and it is a Vaikalikar Murma, Soumya, and having a half angular pramana. And I already explained that how you approach in this way, in this way, in this way. So by putting your thumb inside and you can stimulate, press, release, press, release, press, release. And each stimulation is of 0.8 second. And for any type of ailment, if a person is suffering from any auditory ailment, then you have to stimulate 15 to 18 times. And if a person is healthy, then only 5 to 8 times stimulation is enough. So now come to the next point, which I am just coming. That is the Bhruva Antara Rupari Karna Lalato Madhye, that is Sankhu. This is the Sankh, and you all know that this is a very vital point, that is, this is known as temple. This area is known as temple, and you all know that this point is Satya Pranahar Varma having an Agni in quality. And always remember one thing, that whenever you are describing any Marma, and it is very important in the Satya Pranahar Varma, it is Agni in nature. The Agni itself indicates that the Marma is a supreme powerful, that area is supreme powerful and also vulnerable. So if you, what type of result you want, if you give trauma or injury to that point, then it leads to immediate death. While if you stimulate properly, then definitely it'll give a positive result. So this is a very important point, that is Sankha. And you all know it is as temple bone, and it is of Sadhya Pranahar Marma, Agni Asobhava, and Ardhangula Pramana. And it is very excellent in just making the apana vayugati, which whenever it is pratilom, it does to anulom. So whenever you observe that, whenever you are in empty stomach conditions and having a headache or acidity, you put your finger here and you used to stimulate this point, and you got results. Definitely this marma point has direct action on the apana vayu, while also in the intestinal movement. So as well as the sensation of touch is also controlled by this Sankh Marma. So this is, my dear friend, this is a very important Marma point. So all the points, these are very important. And now just coming to the next point, that is in the just where your eyebrow ends, just look this point and you just touch these points. You feel the pulsation and the pain over these points. You just observe the sensitivity of these points. Just put your finger between the imaginary line drawn from the pinna to the Bhruvantra, and at the Sankha positions, just observe the sensation and the pulsation here at the Sankha region. Just try and observe this sensation and pulsation. You can feel it. You just feel it. And just press here, press here, press here, press and release, press and release, press and release, and you got the results. In the same way, this is the Apanga Marma. Apanga is Marma that is just situated at the end of the eyebrow. That is the Apang Sandhi. You all know this Sandhi is known as Apanga Sandhi, and this point is located at the end of the eyebrow, and this is very important Marma points in the sense of, it is in the sense of the refractive errors. If you stimulate these points, there are two nadis, which is known as the Pusa and Gandhari Nadi, which represents the right and left eye channels, and this point is very effective, very effective for enhancing your vision, alochak pitta, as well as many other functions whenever you stimulate, you practice this stimulation regularly, you observe the results. My dear friends, it is not possible to incorporate the whole lecture in 1 hour or 45 minutes. As you all observe that so many of my doctors regularly attend my classes throughout the 1 month. So I'm just giving the Angiresi way of treatment, only a simple method which give you a trailer that what results you will get. So now come to the next point, and it is a very important, you all know, in the glabella, and that is the Sthapani Marma. I already shown a picture of Jacob Miller, in which the person survived 31 years by just, there is a bullet hit here, bullet is here. So this is a point which is Vishalagna Marma, you all know, if we just remove the shalya, the patient, the person may die immediately. But you all know this is a point of third eye illumination, and also in the as you all know that the nadi, six nadi, especially the Payaswini, Sankini, Pusa, Gandhari, Eda, and Pingla, all mix at this point, that is known as the Sthapani Marma, and they just enter in the Susumna Nadi. And you all know that whenever this the Susumna Nadi open, the person's just eye, the third eye, just means the enlightenment occurs. And so this is a point in which you just, if you stimulate by just pressing this finger to this point, where our ladies just put a bindi here over here, and also our Pandit and Guru just put a chandan over here. And we all observe that whenever we forget any point, we just put your our pen in this way, recalling. So this is a very important point, and I not audible. I think that audible. I am audible. I hope that your network is not correct. You just check your network. Please show the PPT. It's not possible. Actually, the PPT is of my routine class. So I'm just giving you my direct demonstration. And so just observe that this point is known as Sthapani Marma, and how you can stimulate. There are two ways of stimulation. One way is just put your finger in this way and just put this like in this way. Just stimulate in this way. So by pressing this point to 15 to 18 times, if you are a person who is suffering from any type of problem, or if you are unhealthy, then just press it 5 to 8 times. And if a person is suffering from any type of ailments related with the different senses, different command coordination, or any type of problem, then you just stimulate this Marma point. The excellent results you will observe, as this Marma points improve your recalling capacity. As well as I just observed that this is a place where the Susumna Nadi and all the remaining the sixth Nadi just incorporate in the Susumna Nadi. So all the senses, sensory control and command center is this point. So I'm just coming to the next point. I will confine my lecture just shortly briefing all the Marma points, having an introduction to all of you that how much important these points are. So next come to the next point, that is Sringataka Marma. You all know that this Marma points is 4 in number, and just internally it is situated at the soft palate, while externally it is just that there is a bone which is in shape of the Sringataka. The Sringataka is Sanskrit word. It is a fruit which is present in the pond or the water. And you all know in the eastern area, eastern region, it is very common. Singhara, it is also known as Singhara. And basically this point, the 4 points, represents the 4 type of senses. One is the senses of smell, sense of hearing, sense of taste, and sense of smell. Means all the senses of smell, auditory senses, taste senses, and the smell senses just come over this point. This is junction of these 6 nadis. Yes, water chestnut is Singhara, you all know. And you just observe, whenever you observe this fruit, there are 4 corners in this fruit. And these 4 corners represents the 4 different senses. One is the sense of auditory senses. Second one is the senses of vision. Third one is the sense of smell. And fourth one is the sense of taste. Four senses. So if you stimulate, how we can stimulate this point? Simply you just put your thumb and index finger over here and just press this point, just release, press, release, press, release, press release, general formula that where whatever the marma point, if you are a healthy person, so 5-time stimulation is essential for self marma therapy. And if a person is suffering from any ailments, then 15 to 18 times stimulation is required. So this is Sringatak marma, and as you all know that this is a marma point having an agni and sadhya pranahar marma. Always remember that all agni marma points are of sadhya pranahar marma, and means immediately fatal, but they are very powerful. As you all know, if you stimulate properly, then your all the senses will proper. Like recent infections also, you all know that the COVID-19 conditions, you all know that the infections enters through the nose, and this first marma is encountered, and that is the Sringatak marma. So the symptoms comes as a loss of smell, there is a loss of taste also. These are common symptoms which are, we observe that primarily whenever the Sringatak marma affected. So you all know that nasa hisirso dwara, and there is an area that is a Little's area which is highly vascular supply, and the nashya karma also, just mode of action of the nashya karma is also through the Sringatak marma. So I just explain you that if you want to approach to Adipati marma and Simant marma, so you have to first meet with this Sringatak marma, which is situated here. Nasa hi sirso dwara means if you want to enter the sir, then you have to first encounter with the Sringatak marma. So in short, I am just explaining that whatever thing you are observing in your outside, that is present in your body. So if your body is a complete pind, and you say that it is a country, then this head region is your capital city, and the prime minister sits over this Adipati marma, and all the five deputy ministers, like the powerful portfolio, having a powerful portfolio, just sits in the form of Simant marma, and the information is sent to these ministers and top ruler by the Vidur marma, and the temple region is also situated here, that is Sankh marma, and for vision there is another marma, that is Apang, one is Avart, and for the command system or for the command control system there is Sthapni marma, and this marma, Sringatak marma, having a second rank other than the Adipati marma, having same nature, that is the Agni Subhava, and having all control over all the senses, like I already explained you, that sense of auditory, sense of smell, sense of taste, and all the senses, basic senses were controlled with this point, and this is known as Sringatak marma. Now come to the next marma point, that is the Phana marma. You all know that nasa hi sirso dwara, so there is a guard is also present here, that is known as the Phana marma, serpent hoods, and these are two in number. And how you approach this point? Simply by small finger, you just press at the alanizai, just pressure, press release, press release, press release, press release, and this is, and the stimulation is in same way, 0.8 second, having a 15 to 18 times stimulation. And you all know that whatever we are inspiring and expiring, which just come in and out through these nostrils, and there are two security guards got given here, that they are known as the Phana marma. You all know the Phana marma are two in number, and they are also of the Vaikalyakar and Soumya Swabhava, and very important marma points. So we just, what we are doing by stimulating these marma points, we are just saying to our God, which is located in the area, in the form of prana, what we are doing, we are just stimulating, we are not pressing, we are not giving any type of injury, we are not giving any type of invasion to these points. We just stimulating, we are just awakening to these points by the awakening of the prana. That's why we are getting the results, different results. So my dear friends, just these are some important points of the head region. When you come to the back region, there are two marma points at the allanto-occipital joint. How you stimulate and approach this point, that is known as Krikartika marma. And Krikartika marma, this is a way to stimulate. Just put your finger, by crossing your fingers in this way, and just put your hypothenar eminence over these two points, which is situated at the allanto-occipital joint, and just press, release, press, release, press, release, press, release. And the same way, if a person is healthy, having no problem like cervical spondylitis or any conditions, then just give a pressure of 5 to 8 times. And if a person is suffering from any type of ailments related with the spine, cervical spine, then 15 to 18 times stimulation is needed. So this is a point which is situated in the neck region. I come to the next point, that is neck region. The marma points of the neck region should not be directly stimulated. The cardiac locations at the allanto-occipital joint between the junction of the head and neck, my dear doctor. And if you just look this point, this is just situated, both two points situated at the allanto-occipital joint. You just put your finger just in cross like, and by this hypothenar eminence, and just to place it over this point and just press, release, press, release, press, release, press, release. So by putting a pressure with these hypothenar eminence to that point, you can stimulate your Tricartica marma. It is very effective for cervical spondylitis, my dear doctors. So now come to the next point. Just I'm discussing about the neck. There are Nila, Manya, Matrika, and Siraya. These are present in the neck region, but the neck points never should be directly stimulated. And there are two techniques for stimulating these points. One is the positive pressure technique, and another is the negative pressure technique. Positive pressure technique is by blowing your mouth in this way. You just stimulate. I already shown you a picture in which Sankha Dhwani, blowing of Sankha is also the indirect way of stimulation of this neck marma. And by protruding your tongue outside, that is a Singhasan condition, you are just creating a negative pressure over this area, and that also incorporates and stimulates your marma points indirect way. So these are the stimulation of some of the important marma points of your head region. And this is also an angiracy way of treatment, because we are not using any type of instruments, neither we are using any type of pin or any type of seats over there. But always remember that there are some code of conduct associated with these marma points. One, never you practice or never stimulate these marma points in standing position. Number one. Number three, to always use the stimulation of these points in lying down or most probably in sitting position. Third thing is that marma points should not be stimulated during a pregnancy. Never stimulate any marma points during pregnancy, as you all know that there is a Sushruta already mentioned that the garbhopaghat karbhav. If you stimulate a marma points in pregnancy, there may be a chances that the child which born will take some inborn errors. So never stimulate these points in pregnancy, and also avoid to stimulate these points in the menstrual period. And one also protocol should be followed, because you are just giving your positive energy to a patient. There are chances that certain times the patient is coming with negative attitude and negative energy. So this energy may influence in your body. So always wear a Rudraksh if you want to practice it regularly. Rudraksh having a positive energy, you all know. And this science just connects with the Lord Shiva. And so always be grateful. If you got good results, then be grateful to that Lord Shiva that yes, these points are given by that God to our body. We are not doing anything. These points are present in the body. We are just acknowledging and just reminding that these points are beneficial for certain ailments. So my dear friends, I just given some example of the marma points. There are so many other points which are associated with many ailments like Ansa marma, Urvi marma, Indravasti marma. I'm just giving an example of the Talhirdaya marma. Talhirdaya marma, one, you just try. I am just giving you an example. If you think it is correct, then you just believe it. Or if you think that there is no result, don't believe on it. You just stimulate, there is a point which is situated, you just draw an imaginary line between the middle finger and just cross it, and just you observe there is a point which is known as Talhirdaya marma. Or you just rotate your finger and just the middle finger comes to a point that is at the Talhirdaya marma. And just you press this point in this way by your thumb, as you all know that this is a Mans marma having Kalantar Prana Harma in quality and half angula pramana. I just giving you a task that you first take a blood pressure of a patient and just stimulate these marma points 15 to 18 times. And after take, if a patient is hypertensive, you just observe that there is a, if there is an hypertension, it comes to the normal 15 to 20 mm Hg difference you observe directly. And the same in case of the hypotension also. So my dear friends, these points are very vital points. And I think that these points, both left and right, Anuradha ji, both left and right, for patients, but for self-Varma therapy, we just stimulate the left side. So self-Varma therapy is another type of way of stimulation. It really works. Yes, it's a Vandana Pathak ji, you already joined my classes, as you know that it really works. So many doctors in the COVID-19 conditions, lockdown is there, and the patients are not able to purchase medicines. And they contacted the doctors that what we can do. And our doctors advised them to just stimulate Talhrudaya Marma, the instant results they got. So there are so many examples, like simply stimulating the Indravasti Marma, the constipation got really relieved. So these are God's given switches in our body. So my dear doctors, I'm just not telling that this is a complete science. I'm just giving you that, just learn this science. This is a value-added technique. It will incorporate your practice, as this organization is also a private practitioner. And I hope that in your, you also encountered with this science very much, and you also may be more knowledgeable than me. But I just put one trailer in front of you that what this science is, the Angirasi way of treatment, and this is a Vedic treatment. Our Vedas are the treasure house of the knowledge. Arshad ji, your question is, any Marma points for sinusitis for complete cure? Yes, you can cure it, but by proper stimulation. So thankful, I'm thankful to Dr. Shyam Mohan ji, Krishna Das ji, I presented the practical the things of the Marma science. If there is any questions, you can ask with me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Wonderful presentation. I felt a lot of a hurricane of knowledge coming our way. Thank you, sir, for that. And I felt that it is very similar to Tamil Marmas that we practice in Shalya Dandra also. And we had a similar class just before in the last month called Pamba Mastery Marma. And we are going to have another module of that with these Marma, sir. You'll also come into the team for that. Let's go to the questions now. We have Dr. Sudhir asking, please explain what is the meaning of name of each Marma, why the particular name given to particular Marmas?
Yeah, like first Varma, just I explained you the Adhipati. The Adhipati means the king, means the Raja, the ruler. So this Varma point is known as the Adhipati, means the king, the ruler. Another, I explained the Simanta, which connects, which joint, which we communicate with the all the Varma points of the head region, that is Simanta. One is the Vidur, which is directly associated with the auditory functions. And another one, I explained you the Sankha, that is the temple, which is situated at the Sankha Asti. Another one, which I explained you the Apanga, that is situated at the Apang Sandhi, but it is of a Sira Marma. While another one is a Sthapani. Sthapani means which establishes a knowledge. Establish. And another one is the Sringatak, which is associated with the fruit, water chestnut, I already explained. And the next one is the Fana, that is associated with the serpent hoods, means for protection, like a security guard. Now come to the next point. You asked about all the Marma points name. So it's a very... I will try to explain you. There are Ansa Marma, that is situated at the shoulder region. Same, the Urvi, which is known as the Bavi Marma. Ani, Kurpara, at the Kurpara Sandhi. Indrabasti, Manibandha. That name itself suggests that what type of Marma point it is. Manibandha, which just take a foundation to your money. And same Shipra, same Talhrudaya. These are some examples of the name. And I hope that you got my answer.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. We have Dr. Anju asking a question now. Dr. Anju? Yes, doctor.
Yeah. Sir, thanks, sir. Excellent lecture, sir. Sir, I wanted to know that when we learn about these marmas, sir, are we supposed as doctors to do on the patient, or should we explain to the patient to do it on daily basis?
Yeah, very, very nice, sir. Question. Very nice question. Doctor, actually, what is the procedure? Whenever in our OPD a patient is coming, So we advise, actually, there are some protocols associated with the stimulation with these marma points. Like the Adipati, Simanta, these marmas should not be stimulated at any time. Always avoid to stimulate at odd times, like immediately after taking food or at midnight. These type of marmas should not be stimulated. So what we do, whenever a patient comes to our OPD, we tell that this is the way of stimulation to their attendant. And we just put a mark on that point. And we tell that just put a mehdi color on that point and just regularly stimulate morning and evening time. The morning and evening time is an ideal time that is known as the Brahma Murta and Trikala Sandhya time. And if a person is suffering from very serious conditions, then we also allow them to stimulate it in 3 or 5 times daily. So these are the way of stimulation. But always we train to the patient's attendant so that they follow up, they stimulate these points.
Before we continue to the next question, sir, I just want to tell the participant about this program that we are co-organizing with Vagbhata Sarani, an organization which has been conducting Ashtanga Hridaya Satram, a program devoted to Ashtanga Hridaya, the text. So if you are a student and if you are interested in learning how to study Ashtanga Hridaya, this is a place where to start. Please do attend. I have already attended during my when I was a student, and I do recommend it. You can contact Dr. M. Prasad, whose number is given below the poster. All the details are available on the WhatsApp groups that we have. And if you are interested, you can contact us, and we will give you the details. Sir, the next question is from Dr. Sonia. She is asking about tonsillitis. Any marma to stimulate?
There are two way of stimulation. One is the neck marmas. As you all know, the tonsillitis is associated with the tonsils, and it is a problem associated with the Vishuddhi chakra. So those marma points having an direct effect on the Vishuddhi chakra, like Ansa marma and the Kantha marma, should be stimulated properly. And I already told that Kantha marma, there are two techniques. One is the positive pressure technique by making this and just by protruding tongue. This technique is more effective for tonsillitis by putting your tongue outside. And another one is the stimulation of the Ansa marma. These combination of the therapy will definitely occur, along with your gargling and other way of treatment you all know for tonsillitis. You just put a combo of these treatment, and that will definitely give you results.
We have Dr. Shilpa now asking a question. Dr. Shilpa, hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, I wanted to ask about the Indrabasti marma. You said now we can use Indrabasti, we can stimulate Indrabasti marma for constipation. So yeah. I wanted to ask when and how, means in morning or in evening or night, means how we have to stimulate and when we have to stimulate.
Well, Shilpa ji, one thing is that if you are doing self-marma therapy, there are two, self-marma therapy is a daily practice routine schedule, which we can practice it in daily. And in that practices, we stimulate our, first of all, marmas of the axial marma, and then we have stimulate our extremities marmas. And these Indrabasti marma comes on the extremities marma. Simply, you can stimulate at the morning time. Morning time and evening time. Evening time, I already mentioned Trikala Sandhya time, in which we offer the prayer to our God. And the morning Brahma Murta, these time are very suitable for stimulation. And preferably empty stomach stimulation is advisable. But if a patient is coming with constipation in your OPD, and at any time, like in night or in daytime, just suggest them to stimulate just below the elbow joint. There are in forefinger down to the elbow joint. There is a point which is known as the Indrabasti marma, and you just observe the result. The constipation will immediately relieve. Not only the constipation, these marma points have a direct effect on the urinary bladder also. So you will get the results. In the case of the bladder is not properly out, means the urinary incontinence, like our senior citizens, today is also a day which is purely devoted with the old age people, and they also suffer from the prostatic problem, benign prostatic hyperplasia, in which the urine incontinence is a routine symptom. Dribbling micturition is a very important symptom. So you just advise them to stimulate the Indrabasti Marma. It is very effective.
Is it, so if any one of the participants want to ask a question directly, they can raise their hand and we will be asking the question to them. We have Dr. Netra who is asking which Marma to be stimulated to improve memory and concentration.
Improve memory and concentration. I already explained that to improve memory and concentration, I advise you to just stimulate your Marma points, Sthapani. Your Marma Sthapani. One is a Sthapani Marma, the Simanta Marma, and the important Marma point. We don't forget this point. This is known as Manibandha Marma. Manibandha Marma is very important for mental coolness and calmness. And the Sthapani Marma, the one Marma, if you ask that which Marma point is very important for improving our concentration and recalling capacity, then I only and only Marma point which I advise that regularly practice stimulates Sthapani Marma along with the Simanta and other Marma points of the head region. And also practice, actually meditation is also, when we meditate, we also put our full concentration on this Sthapani area. And that is, you all know, this is the Agya Chakra. So these points will definitely improve the memory.
Any Marma points to stimulate for obese patients?
Yeah, it's very excellent question, doctor. I just want that this type of question is needed. So stimulation of the Kurpar Marma. Kurpar Marma, how you stimulate Kurpar Marma? So Kurpar Marma is situated at the elbow joint. This is called Kurpar Sandhi. And you just put your thumb in the olecranon process and just put your index finger of the elbow joint traces, and the middle point comes over this point, and this point is known as the Bahya Kurpara. And while the same in at the medial epicondyle, one finger below, you just got the Abhyantara Kurpara Marma. So by pressing the Bahya and Abhyantara Kurpara Marma, as well as in the lower extremity, there is a Marma point that is known as Gulf Marma. So Gulf Marma and Kurpar Marma are very important Marma point for weight management. So it is a tight tested. If you regularly stimulate Kurpar and Gulf Marma for 2 to 3 months and having a dietary proper management, then you just observe the management of weight in your patients as well as in yourself, because the Kurpar Marma directly control your metabolism. So the metabolic related disorders like diabetes, obesity and hypertension is directly controlled by stimulation of the Kurpar Marma. So Kurpar and Gulf.
We have Dr. Anju again. Dr. Anju, hello.
Sir, yes. I wanted to know, like you said, the importance of these five fingers, the thumb, the index. So, sir, at least tell us that for certain marmas, like we need to use only the thumb or only the index, and how do you do this in your clinical practice?
Yeah. Your question is that, is there any specific fingers for specific Marma points? Dear doctor, actually, yes, like for Adipati and Simant, we are using the particular finger for particular Marma points. But one thing I am just clarifying you that for maximum Marma points, we are using either our thumb or our index finger or our middle finger. Only the Fada Marma is only a Marma point in which we are using small finger. So small finger is never used except other than the Fada Marma. And the finger and stimulation correlation is just matched, but it is it always not directly linked with the Mahabhuta and Marma. So it just, our way is that we have to put the stimulation, preferably we use thumb and index finger, and in some cases middle finger also. Small finger is used for only Fada Marma, like we are stimulating the Kurpar Marma. So there are way of stimulation. Either we can just press here with the middle finger, or if a patient is here, this is my self Marma therapy. If a patient is coming and I just stimulate the Kurpar Marma with my thumb. So if preferably we use thumb, index finger and middle finger, and only in case of Fada Marma, we use small finger. So this is the relation of the stimulation with the fingers.
So just want to add one or two bits to this. In Tamil, if you are interested, if in traditional methods, there are people who use a thumb like this, this part, and three fingers like this. Also three fingers like this, equal level. So there are multiple ways in Tamil Marma also, as just to add if you are interested. Sir, the next question is from Dr. Joshi. He is asking, can we do Marma Chikitsa on patients of hemiplegia?
Yes, pardon? Any?
Hemiplegia. Marma Chikitsa on patients with hemiplegia.
Okay, hemiplegia. Yeah, it's very beautiful question. So, Dr. Joshi, for hemiplegia patients, you can stimulate Marma points, like what part is affected, just stimulate the opposite side also. The Marma, if a patient is suffering from the left side hemiplegia, and so you can stimulate right side also and left side also. The affected parts, opposite side Marma points should also be stimulated. And which Marma point? So we have to stimulate all the Marma points, lower extremities, upper extremities, back, as well as of the head. All Marma points should be stimulated in case of hemiplegia.
Dr. Ritika is asking, which Marma can be stimulated in gynec problems like PCOD, infertility, etc.?
Yeah, Ritika, I think Ritika ji, for the gynec problems, the Indraprastha Marma, as you all know, that the radar range of the Indraprastha Marma is up to urinary bladder and uterus, as well as the Marma points of the back, that is Nitamba, Kukundar and Katik Tarun. These three Marma points are very excellent for the gynec disorders. So Indravasti and the Marma points of the back, that is the Nitamba, Katik Tarun and Kukundara. Nitamba, Kukundara and Katik Tarun, these three Marma points are very important for treating the PCOD, PCOS and other gynec problems.
We have Dr. Nagabhushnam asking whether continuous wearing of opticals, earphones, headphones, etc. have any negative or positive effect.
Yeah, definitely. During this COVID situation, everybody is exposing to the screen and mobile, and definitely overall continuous exposure leads to stress also, and also giddiness and vertigo problems also increases day by day. So I advise you that yes, it is a situational problem that we all are confined in our home. So what can we do? We just use our gadgets, but one thing you always do, that by proper stimulating these Marma points time to time, morning time, like the Marma points associated with eyes, the Marma points which relax your body completely, then you can cope up from such type of problem. But Nidana Parivarjan is essential part, so try to avoid these gadgets and multiple exposure to the screen.
Yeah, we have a student asking, how can I practice in the stream of Marma? He's a student. How can he start?
My dear student, it's very easy. I just explained you that these are switches in our body. In my opinion, what is my personal opinion, what Tamil people and what other people are practicing, actually, the God has given the same point in our body. God has never created a difference between Tamil, between north, between south, between east and west. He has given the same points, 107 points, which is mentioned in the Sushruta. And the name is also 7. Yes, the translated name in Malayalam is definitely different, or the Tamil is definitely different. But all the original, the incorporated Vedic science is similar. So these are switches in our body. And the location of the switches as per the Sushruta, that is the vital point, which is vulnerable to trauma and leads to death immediately or after some time, or it will do some vaikalikar, means disability, or it will create a pain. But these are points and which is just a little bit different from that vulnerable area. And by observing the clinical effect of these points, this type of protocol is developed, which I already explained to you during some explanation of some Marma points. So what you have to do, first you have to learn the basic anatomy and the location and identification of this Marma point, and proper studying of the classification of these Marma points, the nature of these Marma points, and what should be done careful, what pressure should be applied for these Marma points, as Shira or Snayu Marma should be pressed less, Mans Marma little bit more, and Asthi and Sandhi Marma maximum bearable pressure should be given, and lot of other things is also there. for a child, for a 90 years plus persons, older persons, careful should be needed. And so if you learn properly, then there is no anything you can't understand it. This is a very simple science. My students learn it. During lockdown, I have trained more than 500 doctors. So maximum of my doctors have joined this session. So this is very easy science. You learn it within 1 month.
We have another question. Proper position of marmas in the neck.
Proper position of the marmas in?
Neck region.
Neck region. So my dear doctor, my guru, Professor Sunil Joshi told me that don't explain the without proper knowledge. Don't I am not entitled to explain you the Nila, Manya, Matrika and Sira. Actually, it is a very dangerous point. Yes, culinary people stimulate these points, I know, but I will not tell you that Nila, Manya, Matrika and Sira, these are very vulnerable points. The carotid artery, the jugular veins and the Manya, and this is at the just lower region. These points are situated in the neck region. So if you want to know, you just go to the anatomy book. You will know the Nila, Manya and Matrika, Sira. I already explained that direct stimulation should be avoided. So I already explained you the indirect technique, that is positive pressure technique and the negative pressure technique. Go to the indirect technique and just observe the results. Don't try to touch these points directly.
We have Dr. Mahima asking which marma we can stimulate in case of adenoid.
Adenoids, yes. In case of adenoids, you can explain the Kurpar marma. Don't forget this Kurpar marma. My dear doctors, Kurpar marma is excellent. For adenoids or any other condition, the Kurpar marma is excellent. Kurpar and the Gulfa, as well as the Janu marma. These marma are having a very, very good importance in the marma science, you all know. So regular stimulation of Kurpar marma definitely just give you results of the adenoids.
We have Dr. Adira asking, which marma to be stimulated in case of myopia? And in general, how much pressure is to be exerted in all marmas?
Yeah, in myopia cases, doctor, there are three marma points. One is, I already explained, that is sangha, and above two finger above the sangha, there is a utset, and at the rohantra, that is a apang. So these three marma points located at the temple region, it's very important, and don't forget about this sringatak marma. So sangha, utakshep, apang, avarta, and sringatak. These marma points are important for myopia as well as the other refractive condition also. So regular stimulation of sangha, utakshep, apang, avart and sringatak definitely will give you a positive results in myopia cases.
Sir, any marmas in case of renal disorders?
Yeah, very good. Very nice question. Renal disorder. My dear doctor, when I explain you Indrabasti marma, so Indrabasti marma is located at just four finger below the elbow joint. So just make your position straight and just like this, and look, your Indrabasti marma comes over your kidney region. So it is just the range of this Indrabasti marma. This is Indrabasti marma, and the range comes to the your kidney. So this is a very important marma, Indrabasti marma, which is a direct effect on the kidney. So not only in the kidney, also in the suprarenal gland. And as Sushruta mentioned, that injury to this marma points leads to the blood loss and patient may die, as it is a Kalantar Prana marma. But this is a one side story. And another side story, I am just telling you, stimulate your Indrabasti marma and look the results on your kidney. So this is an important marma point. When in combination with the Kurpar marma, the Indrabasti marma, if you stimulate, you will get excellent results in the renal problem as well as in the cases of diabetes also. So it is a very important Indrabasti.
Yes, sir. We have Dr. Anuradha asking for insomnia, which marma?
Yeah, insomnia. Yes. Anuradha ji, I am just giving you an example. Today, just try. There are two marma points, one at just below the thumb and having a four finger area, that is known as Kurcha marma. Today, you just stimulate your Kurcha marma now and Kurcha marma and between the Manibandha and the Kurcha marma, there is a point. This is the point that is known as the Kurcha sira. So this is a Kurcha marma and this is the Kooch Sir Marma. So stimulate Kooch and Kooch Sir. Same point is situated in your foot also, at the just at your sole, at the sole just below the your great toe. There is a Kooch Marma, and at the plantar area where your heel bone is there, heel, and that is also Kooch Sir. So by just simply stimulating this Kooch and this Kooch Sir, as well as the Kooch and Kooch Sir of the lower extremity, the insomnia patients, you got instant results. It is a very effective Marma points, and directly associated with vision also, directly having an effect on the Alochak Pitta also. So advise your patient to stimulate Kooch and Kooch Sir Marma. And when you clap, when we clap, then simply we stimulate our Kooch and Kooch Sir Marma. So these Marma points are very effective for insomnia cases.
We have Dr. Banita asking, in pre and post menopausal syndrome, which Marmas can be stimulated?
Yeah. So Ranjitaji's question is very nice. Ranjitaji, actually pre and post menopausal syndrome, the Marma points of the back, as well as I already explained the Manibandha Marma, the Kurupar Marma, and Indravasti Marma, these Marma points are very effective. So my advice to all of you, that always practice self Marma therapy. Self Marma therapy is a way in which you can maintain your problems like postmenopausal syndrome and other problems. You can control these problems by practicing the regular stimulation of the Marma. So self Marma therapy and stimulation of the certain Marma points like Indravasti, Urpara, Manibandha, these Marma points, you will get results on, as well as the Marma points to the back, that is Katik, Tarum, Hritamba, and Kukundara. These Marma points, you will get benefits in such cases also.
Okay, sir. We have a Dr. Deepa asking, points to relieve from vertigo, and also to stimulate certain points to remove obstruction of Arthavaha Srotas.
Yeah. So for vertigo, I already explained, there are allanto-occipital joint. There is a Marma point that is known as the Karkatika Marma. Whenever you go to the barber saloon, then you already massage to this point, and that point is situated at the back, allanto-occipital joint, where your neck connects with your head. There is a joint that is known as the allanto-occipital joint. There are two Marma points, and just you stimulate in such a way. And another thing is that what is the question? I forget. One is
about obstruction of Arthavaha Srotas.
Arthavaha Srotas, yes. So Arthavaha Srotas, the main Marma point is, again I am explaining you, the Indravasti Marma. Indravasti Marma, as well as the Vitup Marma. If a female just put his the ankle to the groin region near to the Vitup Marma and Lohitaksh Marma, these Marma points are just situated at the groin region. So whenever we are sitting in the Siddhasana position, so automatically these Marma points stimulated. Now one thing I advise to my all lady doctor, that always sit on the Vajrasana position. In Vajrasana position, actually, when you sit in the Vajrasana position, there is a specific Vajrasana position in which we touch our both the Gulf Marma as well as the Chipra Marma side by side, and the ankle bone touches to a specific point that is known as Katik Tarun Marma. So by simply sitting on the Vajrasana position, actually we are stimulating the Marma points of the back, and I already explained that the back Marma points is a very good for treating such Arthavaha Srotas Dushti cases.
Yeah, we have Dr. Deepali asking, is there any need for inhalation and exhalation each?
Yeah, definitely. Deepali, it is a very nice question. Whenever you are putting pressure to a Marma point, whenever you are putting pressure, then the exhalation should be done. Why this happened? Why this? The concept of this science is that whenever you are pressing to a Marma point, you are just putting a positive energy to a point. And by certain points at certain range, like the Kurpar Marma of the right side had a direct nearest relation with the liver as well as the gallbladder, while the left side Kurpar Marma has a direct relation with the spleen and the pancreas. So whenever you are stimulating a corresponding Marma point, what you are doing, you are actually putting a positive energy to that point, and by your positive energy stimulation, that point, that organ revitalize itself, re-energize itself, and it immediately releases its negative energy outside. And you all know that positive and negative energy correlation is directly related with the inhalation and exhalation. So when we are putting pressure to a point, then the negative energy go outside, and so we have to exhale. So press, exhale. Whenever we are pressing to a point, we have to exhale. And whenever we are putting, releasing the pressure from a point, we have to inhale. So press, exhale, and release, inhale. This fundamental point you must have to keep in your mind.
Another question is there any specific marma for regularization of periods in case of thyroid?
Yeah. Definitely. The thyroid problem is directly related with the endocrine system. And endocrine system, there are Ans marma. You just try to stimulate your Ans marma, which is located at the coracohumeral ligament and glenohumeral ligament. And just the way of press is just put your shoulder in 90 degree and hand in 45 degree, and put your index finger at the junction of the neck and the shoulder, and the middle finger comes to that point that is known as Ans marma. And just for always remember that females should have to stimulate first left side and then right side. This is the proper protocol associated with the stimulation of the marma points of the extremities. So stimulate your Ans marma. Another marma is the Chipra marma. Chipra marma is just situated at this thumb and this index finger. There is a web, and you just put your next thumb to here and just stimulate this marma point. And this marma point definitely will give you relief on the thyroid problems and all other problems related with the endocrine system.
Okay, sir. Next, we have a question. There are some difference of opinion about exact position of Kukundara marma. Can you please clarify the exact position?
Yeah. Actually, what happens, my dear doctor, there are difference of opinion in all the marma points locations. Why is it? Why actually Sushruta has given the certain points, mentioned certain points. Actually, he was a surgeon, and he just mentioned these points according to the surgical point of view, that we have to safeguard these points. Actually, what happens, these protocols is developed by our acharya and gurus by their long clinical practices. So these points have taken a little bit, some millimeter or some inches different from that point which is mentioned in the Sushruta. Already I explained that in case of Indrabhasthi marma, it is mentioned that it should be at the mid of the head, but we take it fourth finger below. Kundara marma is just below, four finger below the Nitamba, and exactly it is just above the Katik Taruna marma. Katik Taruna marma is situated at the greater sciatic notch, while Kukundara marma, you all know that it is situated at the sacroiliac joint. So always remember that there are some differences, but only one thing you have to remember, that when you sit in Vajrasana position, your ankle comes over the point that is known as Katik Tarun, and above the Katik Tarun, the marma point, which is known as Kukundara. And another example is that when you sit on the Supta Vajrasana position, Supta Vajrasana is a position, unique position, by practicing Supta Vajrasana position, actually you are directly stimulating your all three marma's points, that is Kukundara, Nitamba, and Katik Tarun. So it is, I think that it's very clear.
So there are other presentations that we had before, in Resolute. And if the participant are interested, they can go back to our website and see those videos. And there are multiple opinions, as sir said. So if you are interested in knowing other opinions, there are videos there with presentations and all. If you are interested, you can go. We have a doctor. Next question. About surgery. Will marma chikitsa give better effect in anesthesia complicated patients?
Means you are asking that post-surgical cases.
I think she is asking about people who are having some allergy to the drug.
Definitely. Doctor, it is a non-invasive, non-surgical, and no expense. means you are nothing, you are what you are doing. You are simply just putting your finger over a point and stimulating that point. You are not writing a prescription. You are not giving any invasion. The switch is already present in his body or in her body. So it's very easy for any. So if there is Janu Marma stimulation is so much beneficial for those cases in which surgery is advised for joint replacement. So by stimulating simply the Janu Marma, definitely the surgical intervention should be avoided. So I think that this is the best therapy, best way of treatment, in which the cost effectiveness is also there, non-invasion is also there, non-surgical is also there. And if you don't get any result, you are not giving any harm to patient. So why you are not following, my dear doctors? And one thing which previously the moderator asked, that there are so many differences in the lectures. One thing I told you, the basic difference is due to what actually the people are following the different way of the stimulation. And they also certain times they incorporated the name of the different marmas points. And I also telling you that certain people are claiming that we have identified 30 more points in body. But my dear doctors, which I started this lecture from the name of the Lord Shiva. And I also explained that that Lord Shiva, which is Niranjana Nirakara, he is an incarnator of many science like Nadi Vigyana and Marma Chikitsa. So he gives each and every person the simple switch, having same location, no any difference. You observe that, just count the distance, the finger distance between your elbow joint and wrist joint. It always of 16 finger in all of you. Your body is measured in particular same measurement. So God has not created any difference giving any type of distribution of these points or these body's part. So we people also we have no right to give a difference of opinion in these points. The points are same, which is mentioned in Sushruta. Yes, the clinical application may be a little different in some points, like Indrabasti Marma, like Ani and Urvi Marma. There may be some difference, but these differences are not so much maximum two fingers or one finger difference. So overall, in my opinion, the knowledge is same and the thing is also same, but only the clinical aspect, there may be certain difference. Actually, this depends on the experience of a Vaidya.
We have Dr. Ram Govel asking, what is the mode of action of these stimulations?
Yeah,
are the results of pain temporary or permanent?
Yeah, this is a very common question. Very common question, Dr. Ram. Actually, the body is our inner pharmacy. What we are doing actually by stimulating our marma point, we are just recharging our inner pharmacy. Actually, what happening, the body itself heal. We are just putting a stimulus and body itself heal. We are just giving a stimulus to body or certain organs by giving a pranic energy, positive energy, and that energy will just sensitize that vital organs to maintain their proper function. That another question is that its effect is temporary or permanent. My answer is that if a person is not regularly practicing the stimulation of marma point, like self marma therapy, there are certain conditions like in frozen shoulder, you got 7 or 10 days, the patient will okay. So in that cases, there is no need of stimulation further. But in certain cases, like there are CP cases of cerebral palsy and so many cases, paralysis cases, hemiplegia, paraplegia, in which you have to give stimulation for a long time. So in chronic cases, the long-term follow-up is needed. Yes, the effect is permanent. But my dear doctor, this is same like if you are not starting your car from last 1 month and you think that your battery will work proper, it's not possible. So these are same thing that you have to recharge, stimulate these points regularly. So if you want the desired effect should be permanent, you have to advise your patient that yes, your obesity is now controlled, your weight is now managed, but don't forget to stimulate your Kurpar and Gulf Marma. If you stop the stimulation of these Marma points, your weight will regain. So always you have to keep this in mind that this is not a rocket science. You have to stimulate, long-term follow-up is needed. And yes, definitely the effect is permanent.
The question is regarding the weight only. So which Marma to be stimulated for gaining weight?
Gaining weight.
Weight. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So my dear doctor, the weight management, I already explained that there is a Marma point is not associated with gaining or losing. Marma points always decide that what the point, what the energy should, how it works. So it decides if you are stimulating your Talarda Marma. So it doesn't work on the blood, high blood pressure to low blood pressure or low blood pressure to high blood pressure. It manages. If your blood pressure is high, it manages to a normal level. If it is low, it manages to normal level. In the same way for weight management, same way the stimulation of the Kurpar and Gulf Marma, if the weight gain is needed, then also the same stimulation is required for these Marma points, Kurpar and Gulf. And if the patient is overweight, then simply the same stimulation will manage the weight. So the Marma stimulation actually manages the clinical conditions. So you can observe the positive desired effect as well as the negative effect. One, I'm just giving example of a Marma point that is known as Kshipra Marma, which is situated at your great, between a great toe and first toe at the phalangeal joint. You observe that a sadhu mahatma santa, which we are khadau, and always the Kshipra Marma continuously pressed. And in that case, the brahmacharya and mano nigra is the desired effect. Means a sadhu mahatma santa, which wears a khadau, Kshipra Marma is already pressed continuously, and the brahmacharya and mano nigra is a desired effect. But for a grihastha ashram person who needs a family, the brahmacharya and mano nigra is not essential for that person. So simply stimulation of the Kshipra Marma enhances the libido. So it is a practically tested way. So you can observe both the effect. Means if you want to the positive side, means the underweight patient, you can increase the weight. And if overweight patient, you can control the weight. So management is the appropriate word stimulated associated with the stimulation of this Marma.
Sir, next question is which Marmas can be stimulated at the time of cardiac arrest?
Yeah, very nice. Excellent question. The doctor who asks, I appraise.
Dr. Sunil Kumar.
Dr. Sunil Kumar. Dr. Sunil Kumar, I'm just giving you one tip. Follow this thing. Just look, always practice this. Just put your finger in this way and just put, if you are male, then right side, this palm should be in right side at the Urvi and Ani Marma, and just put your hand in this way. And simply, now you are just over the Stana Moola, Stana Rohita, Hridaya and Apastamba Marma. So by simply pressing, exhale, press, exhale, press, exhale, press, exhale, press, exhale. This is a one way, and another again follow the same in the another way. Just put now this in another way. Yeah, and just press, release, press, release. When you are pressing, you just exhale. When you are releasing, just inhale, exhale, inhale. One thing, another thing is that just put your this in over the heart and just like this, and just put a pressure with your elbow as well as this part to the heart, Stana Mool, Stana Rohit and Apastamba Marma. This is simply a cardiac massage as well as the stimulation of all these three Marma points associated with the cardiac problems. And cardiac massage, this is simply cardiac massage technique. And what you ask that if there is a certain immediate cardiac problem, then you have one important Marma point that you all know, this is Talhrudaya Marma. Talhrudaya Marma, which is located at the palmar aponeurosis, is a very important point and immediately give you positive effect in case of cardiac arrest. But don't forget, if you want to make ensure your cardiac health proper, then you have to stimulate the Hridaya, Stana Mool, Stana Rohit and Apastambha Marma regularly.
May I also suggest to Dr. Sunil to, you know, go and see the video of Adangal Murais, which is, we have videos of that, I believe, on our website. You can go and see. Sir, the next question is, please explain Marma points for skin conditions and asthmatic conditions.
Yeah, your condition is the skin. Marma points for skin conditions. Yeah, my answer is again, for any type of the metabolic problems related with the skin conditions, you have to stimulate the Kurpar Marma. Kurpar Marma have a very good effect on skin conditions. So many doctors give instant results in many cases of skin. But again, I tell you that always keep this in your mind that every treatment method has a certain importance as well as certain limitations. So Marma therapy is very good for treating the frozen shoulder, for the brachial plexus injury, for cervical spondylitis, for back ache, for many problems related with the paraplegia, hemiplegia, as well as the senior citizens problem related with incontinence of urine, as well as the gynec disorders. But always remember that there are certain limitations also. So you have to use this therapy as a value-added technique. So you can't claim that in each and every conditions this will work. Yes, you apply this science as a value-added science, and parallelly you also use the Saman Chikitsa, Shodhan Chikitsa, so you will get the instant and very effective results. So my dear doctor, your question, I'm just giving answer. The Kurpar Marma is the best Marma point for skin conditions.
For asthmatic conditions, sir. Asthmatic.
Asthmatic conditions, the Ani and Urvi Marma, and in COVID-19 cases also, the Ani and Urvi Marma, which just at the range of the lungs. And if you stimulate these Marma points immediately, you will get the desired effect like breathlessness and other things. Immediately, you got the results. So Ani and Urvi Marma is a very important Marma point, which is just related with the lungs, as well as the Brihati Marma, which is situated at the back. These Marma points are very important, having a direct effect on the lungs.
We have Dr. Anju now. Dr. Anju, hello.
Yeah. Sir, can you please tell us about like the Marma, which we can stimulate for peripheral neuropathy?
Yeah, thank peripheral you, neuropathy. Anjuji, you have to stimulate, first of all, I advise you to stimulate all the Marma points of the upper extremity and the lower extremities in sequence. First of all, start from the lower extremities, from Chipra, from Talhirdaya, Chipra, Gulpa, Indrabasti, Janu, Ani, Urvi, and again, just come upward to the back region. First, you stimulate Katik Tarun, Kukundar, Mitam, then again Parshandhi, then again Brihati, then come to the Ans, Ani, Urvi of the upper extremity, Kurpar of the upper extremity, Bayakurpar and Abhyantar Kurpar, Indravasti, Manibandha, Chipra, Talhirdaya. So these Marma points should be stimulated properly in the sequence for in the cases of the neuropathy. But special care should be done for the Indravasti and Kurpar Marma as they have direct effect. But stimulation of all the Marma points is very essential.
Another question, if a patient is suffering from Pittadikya Vikara, is it fair to stimulate Agneya Marmas?
Yes, your question is that the Agneya Marma for Pittadikya Vikara, as you all, but in my opinion that always remember that Agneya Marma should always be not, these Marma points are not regularly advised to stimulate. As you all know, but I am just giving you an example that yes, the country has a prime minister, but for all small problems, it's not essential that you approach to prime minister. So the Agneya Marmas are very furious in nature and they have a very powerful Marmas, but they are very dangerous also. So the name is also Adhipati, Simant, Sankh, Srangatak, these Marmas. And maximum Marma points are very Soumya and Vaikalyakar and gentle. So my dear doctor, don't need to go to those furious Marma regularly. There are 44 Marmas which are very gentle. They are Soumya. So you approach these Marma points for Pittadikya Vikara and definitely you will get result. But don't forget that the Agneya Marma have a control in all of the body. So it is not fair that they are not useful for treating such conditions. But always avoid the Sadhya Pranahar Marma or Agniya Marma point to approach in small or any small problems to these Marma points, as these Marma points have a certain adverse effect also.
Next is about Rudraksha. Ekamukha Rudraksha is to be one, or any type of Rudraksha will
no,
be
No, it's my opinion. Actually, Rudraksha is a tree in which the Rudraksha is a fruit. Rudraksha seed. You can wear any type of Rudraksha, as it is mentioned that in Shastra also it is a Rudraksha. It is connected with Lord Shiva, and it safeguard yourself from the negative energy. So there are chances that one thing I just mentioned all of you, I think that for Marma practitioner, first of all, you have to be positive. If you are negative, you will not get the results, because a patient is treated by your positive energy. Always remember this. If you are negative and you are having no confidence on your pathy, no confidence on your therapy, so don't avoid to treat the patients. As the patient is already very negative, so there may be chances that his negative energy comes incorporate in your body and it leads to many side effect or adverse effect to your body. So always remember that, first of all, for a good Marma practitioner, first of all, you have to practice self Marma therapy in your body. So you have to follow positive energy, positive recharge, vitality and positive health, enjoy to yourself. And when you are positive, then only apply this therapy to the patient, as the patient is always Rugna. He came with a lot of problem, lot of negativity. And if you are also negative, then you wear either Rudraksha or anything, it doesn't work. First of all, practice self-marma therapy for your good health. And if you are positive, then just yes, you are if observing 50 to 60 patients daily in your OPD and you are stimulating the marmas. So there may be chances that yes, a little bit, it influences your negativity. It will create certain negativity. So in that cases, you can wear Rudraksha and no specific Ekmukhi or any type of Rudraksha. Only Rudraksha, it should be original. You can wear it. It's like a shield. It works like a shield. Yeah.
Okay. We have Dr. Sandeep asking a question.
Hello, sir. Sir, any Marma stimulation for Arsha, sir?
Yeah, Arsha, actually, you all know that for Arsha, the Guda Marma, the Aswini Mudra, and the Mool Bandha always just constrict and relax, constrict and relax. Actually, this is also Sabde Pranahar Marma, Guda Marma, and Agni nature. So regular stimulation is not required, but yes. And for the Arsha or Buddha problem, anorectal problems, you all know the constipation is the main cause. So Indravasti Marma and the Kurpar Marma stimulation is also very much effective in such cases. But Mool Bandha and Aswini Mudra is a very much important way to avoid these conditions. And remember the Indravasti and Kurpar Marma.
Okay, there is a question, sir. Is there any practice of Marma that can replace anesthesia in anorectal surgeries?
Actually, for anorectal surgeries and the replacement of anesthesia, yes, there are in the anal region, there is a point in which if actually the point will be just stimulated, we also observed that the pain is less during that, during the Chhat Sutra and other parasurgical process. But actually, in routine clinical practice, we don't stimulate these Marma points, so it's so I can't say that it replaced the anesthesia. But yes, definitely, some people also claim that by practicing the Jalandhar Bandha, they just remove the tooth extraction. So my experience is not so much in this field, but I just observed that certain doctors, like they are dental practicing, Ayurvedic dental practitioners, they are claiming that just we are removing the tooth by applying simple Jalandhar Bandha. Definitely, that also stimulates certain Marma points of the Manya region. And simply the same thing, a certain anorectal surgeon also claims that yeah, there are certain points that when you stimulated, they're painless, less pain is observed. So my experience is not so much, so I can't say, but yes, it may be.
Is it? So the last question, I believe, is from Sanakar, Dr. Sanakar. Which Marma have to be stimulated for long time lumbar pain, backache?
Lumbar pain, I think. Lumbar pain, na? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ansa Phalak and Brihati. These two Marma points, along with the the marma points of the back region. These marma points are very effective, and for the lumbar pain, it is advisable that the posture and the spine position is also a very important. So there are one techniques in which we advise to our patients, that is just put your finger in this position and just put your this in the back region and just come upward up to the brihati marma and just do a massage. Just put your like thumbs up position and just put a massage over the brihati and just put upward and downward direction, and it will give a soothing effect. So brihati marma and sifalak marma, these marma points are very important for the lumbar problems.
Okay, sir. Thank you. That'll be the last question for today. Thank you, sir, for coming here and sharing the knowledge. In Tamil, the marma word means secret. But you have shared your knowledge with us. Thank you for that. Yes. Sir.
Thank you for the PAMPA, the private practitioners organizations, which give me a valuable chance to your platform and to interact with your all doctors. Whatever knowledge I have, I just try to share it to you. I already know that you all are very knowledgeable persons, and already you know about these marmas, as many of the speakers already came and delivered their speeches to your platform. But yes, what I just want to present that, yes, these points are the points the God resides in your body. This is God, prana is God, and that resides in your body. Don't need to go to temple or a masjid, mosque or gurdwara. You just body, you just enhance your energy, internal energy, by stimulating these marma points and make your life very smooth and healthy. That's my only opinion to present here.
Thank you. Let me call upon Dr. Suresh PK, our treasurer, to hand over the certificate to you, sir. Suresh, sir.
Yeah, thank you. The certificate is there.
Yes, sir. No, yes. One second, sir.
So I accept your certificate. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Yes, sir. So I think there is some network problem with Dr. Suresh. Hello, sir.
No, but your presentation is very nice. And before attending your presentation, I observed the Ashtanga Hriday Sutra. It's excellent. Amazing. The chanting of the sutras, excellent.
Let's move on, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. We'll be closing now. So tomorrow we have Dr. Rekha having a discussion on Unmada, Manasika Rogas. Please do join us tomorrow. And there are a few new people here, I just want to tell them that we have each and every day we have different subjects in Resolute. Please do join us. Let this be a community of Ayurvedic people learning each day and improving our science. So do come tomorrow. I have to thank my team, Dr. Shabana Balsham, Dr. Rahul J, Dr. Veena Biragunathan, Dr. Anisa Sashraf, Dr. Rajasri Tia, Dr. Pooja, and Dr. Fatimat KK, and Dr. Sudhi Radhakrishnan. So thank you all for participating. If you have any suggestions or questions, please contact me in the number below. Please let your friends and colleagues know about this class so that everyone can benefit. My number is 960-550-9999, and the website where you find all the videos will be www.pambaayur.org. Just a thought for tomorrow morning when you wake up. Train your mind to see good in every situation. Do not go behind negative stuff. As Dr. Naveen said, you should be positive. Always be positive. So with that, let us all grow together. See you all tomorrow. Thank you. Have a good day. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.